How's it going? It's been a while, and I'm sorry. Hi. We have returned from the previously on Able Love Charlie. I was working on unpicking the parachute, which is kind of fun. But I need a break from that. In the slow grind as we approach the end of the school year, my brain can't be dealing with setting up the camera. So I'm going to do some drawing today, which can you actually see? My cursor, you can, which is great. I hope you're all well and having a good morning or afternoon or wherever you are at, time zone. Yeah, we're back with the Huey on, which I had to reset up because they installed new drivers, and then I forgot that I would delete the entire folder that had my backup in whilst I was doing that, which is very sensible. So we're back to doing some artwork. So previously on Able Love Charlie, I'd been doing some drawing that I've been spending ages on with the idea that I was going to produce work that was going to be individual pieces digitally printed onto fabric. But for this, I've done two I really like, and then I was working on a third one and I was really pleased with it for a while, and then it just was bad art. So I've decided to do something different. Well, not different. I'm working on a different weapon today. As you can see, I have done absolutely nothing to it. I don't kind of know what I'm doing. I'm just trying stuff out. It's probably the best way I can describe it. Also, I've messed around, scientifically experimented, of course, with my settings on my mic. I'm going to get another wind filter or pop filter for it. So if things sound a bit different and they're not good, please let me know. Give me some feedback so I can adjust it. I think my voice should be a bit louder whilst being compressed enough that if I laugh a lot, I have to talk quite quietly because of where I live. So I'm laughing there and I can see that I'm almost peaking, but not quite. So I'm not doing too badly. I want to keep my voice down as best I can because other people live around me really closely. But the difficulty is obviously not having it too loud, not having it too quiet. So I was reading up all this stuff. So I have a Go XLR Mini, which I love. Super useful, really good choice of investing the money. I was reading all these people writing about their experience and what settings they put for the particular mic I have. And they just must live in really big houses or very well insulated flats. Because like I've said before on stream, I can hear my neighbour snoring. And so I have to really keep my voice to a reasonable level, even though I'm quite a voluble person in person, which is kind of interesting because whenever I stream, whenever I record, I try really hard not to come across as monotone, mumbling Andy, but it seems to happen because I don't want to be too loud. Anyway, it's 5:30 where I am. I've spent about 3 hours messing around with mics and browsing things and, you know, zero artwork has happened. So I want to set up a stream of my sewing machine, me sewing the parachute. But to do that, it's so stupid. So I think I can stream using an old phone that I have. So as the camera. So I can set that up and I have a power connector there, so that's not too bad. I'm ordering a phone holder so that I can adjust it hopefully get it to where it needs to be. But then it's all about the sound. So I have some wireless headphones that I use when I want to disco dance around my flat or when I'm cooking. But to get those to go into the Go XLR, I need a different connector that I don't have. I also need, it's just complicated, and I was browsing wireless mic sets, so just body pack things, so I can have an actual stereo mic, so I would be officially like Britney Spears rather than with a straw like I usually do. But then this is money I don't really want to spend, and so I bought a £7 cable to see if I can make it work, in that I need to run it out of the Go XLR and into my computer. Yes, so there we have it. I spent hours this morning doing that, which is not very useful. But I'm going to try the cheap thing first, because what I'd really like to do is be able to talk to you in chat rather than just type to you, which is just not as good. Not as immediate, not as back and forth, Twitch chatty, joyous. So yeah, I need to have a just chatting art chat screen. And it's really cold. It's really cold at the moment. So let me just load up some things that you can't see. So I've got Colorus and I've got Brushbox. Let me just wait for Brushbox to load up because it's often quite slow. They need to have some sort of setting where, just like they have a Discord setting where it mutes everything. They need to have something like that, an anonymity browser, But if you need to use files, and then, I mean, what are you going to see? Not very much, but I still want to safeguard my privacy. There should be different profiles you can have, like on Firefox, Fox, or Chrome, to be able to switch that in terms of what is shown on Windows and what isn't. Anyway, so I kind of want to be able to show you. So at the moment I am just capturing Photoshop, but I can capture it in a different way, so I can show you what I'm doing. I can just show you the different things in terms of what I'm selecting, what brushes I'm using. How much that brings to things, I don't know. Anyway. Ooh, it's the first yawn of the day. Well, the stream. So I was going to do something with this. Again, I really like this photo in the sense of the aesthetics of it. You've got this gratuitous silver plated AK. You've got this green kind of gross marble effect. And then you've got this marble background and the rug. So it looks like it's on the floor. So they look like floor tiles of some sort. Could be wall tiles, but no, they can't be wall tiles. They must be floor tiles of some sort. Or flooring of some sort with something that looks a bit like marble. So I've seen that kind of effect. It's raspberry ripple effect on some of the other AKs I've seen, where they have this kind of grim raspberry ripple effect. So this is not aesthetically pleasing. But it's interesting. It's just a bit gratuitous, so that's why I choose it, because it's kind of gross, I think. So we should probably do some drawing or work out what we're doing with this. Or maybe we won't do anything at all and I'll just talk to Twitch chat for an hour and a half. Except when I say Twitch chat, I mean talking to myself, because it's just me and I don't even think there are any bots at the moment. Pepe Hands. But yeah, we've got some exciting new Christmas emotes, which is very exciting. I even have a Christmas desk chan. Let me just put that in chat. Hold on. What are you, Christmas desk chan? Look at that. I see her. Amazing. Twitch chat is something different now, so it tells me like a new message has been sent. Is that a setting on? Hold on a minute, let me just see whether that is a setting on Frankaface. Interesting. Okay, let's do some actual artwork. I mean, I could just mess around, to be honest, because, I don't know, it's been a while. Still getting used to the Huey on. What brush shall we use? Let's try a nice pen. Yeah, let's just try and mess around for a bit and get used to this. Oh. Oh, something weird's happening. Pressure is not what I want for this. Let me just adjust. I did already adjust it. See if that's any better. Let's not use that pen. Why is the let's start up Lazy Nozomi. That'll be important. Why is the pressure not working on this? Where are you, my little friend? Okay, why are you being weird, Photoshop? Photoshop's having a freak out. Look, it's losing the plot. It's about to crash. Oh, okay. Yeah, what is going on here? Lazy Nozomi is having some sort of freak out. Okay, let's close this and let's try just messing around. Let's restart. Actually, let me update Lazy Nozomi. Just do this for you. Okay, let's just do some messing around. Beautiful. So it looks like this might be working now, possibly. Let's try sharp small again. Let's see if it freaks out. Oh yeah, we're all good now. I don't know what Photoshop was doing before, but it was, or Lazy Nazimi, but it was not what we wanted. So I'm just pondering what I'm going to do with this. God, is it doing the weird thing again? Thank you. was watching there's an artist I follow on Twitter who also live streams. I really love his work. It's a very distinctive style called Mikal G, I think his name is. And I was watching him draw, and something really struck me about using digital tools. So I take an age to draw stuff because I'm very careful about where I'm placing my line. But what people seem to do who draw digitally is they just do lots and lots of lines and just undo them over and over and over and over again, which is a different way to draw completely. It's not expressive. It's very small bits. And it was really interesting to watch him draw because that just seemed the complete opposite to how I would do it on a piece of paper, where you can draw expressively and you draw, 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 and then you erase out what you don't need. But this idea of you just draw one line and then you undo, 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 redo, undo, you know, backwards and forwards was quite interesting because, again, it's just really different. Yeah. I don't know what I'm doing with this. I'm just sort of... Somehow these bits seem important. Then they don't. Explosive of fireworks going off outside. Hopefully you don't hear them, but maybe you do. I'm sorry if you do. So I guess it's the whole thing where I'm just waiting for inspiration to strike. I kind of know what I want to do. Let's do something productive and go around the gun. Why did I do that? I didn't need to do that. Let's get rid of that. Let's call this the gun lair. Okay. Oh. Oh God, what's going on? What is... Oh, just my entire... Oh. What? Hold on a second. I wonder whether... Let me just see how my hard drive is going on. It's got enough. I need to uninstall some things off my Windows drive. Thank you. So what I'm trying to do at the moment is I am cutting out this so I can use it as a template. I had to see what was going on there with it can't, does that start end there and then it continues on, or does this go down and then go around? I mean, it doesn't really make sense to go further down, but then it does look like there's something there. Something like that. Okay, a little bit off piste here, but whatever. Hey Harsh Harsh, how's it going? I remember you very kindly gave me a follow last stream, for which I am very appreciative. I hope that your day is a good one so far. My day's not been too bad, thanks. Just lots of technical support stuff, trying to work out what I'm doing. Hmm. No parachute work this week, I'm afraid, as I need a break, as things are very tiring at work. Girl. What am I working on? I am working on a hideously customized. So my inspirational starting point is a hideously customized Iraqi AK, which has been silver plated and has got this kind of gross green marble effect on it. So I'm cutting this out so I can use it as a template, and actually I have managed to actually cut that out. It's great. Cut out the rest of this bad boy. Now I have this taken out of the background. Just unsee that. So now, what is on here? Oh, it's the squiggles. Squiggles, which are actually kind of interesting. Just save that. Select this, and then we will fill it. Which I don't know why I just did that. That was really whatever. Let's fill it. Let's do. Color should we go for? This color. Whoops, that was not what I intended to do. Do select inverse. If I could actually remember to do that, would be helpful. Okay, it kind of looks a bit crunchy looking. So we'll just clean up small spaces, small things that could probably do with being cleaned up. Make the edges a little bit less rough. Could use a rubber for this, but whatever, man. Dubious. Dubious. Thank you. Clean up this front section because I don't think I need those bumps. Let me just shove this over. Whoop. Alright. Yeah, I'm still working out what I want to do with this. I do like those kind of crazy squiggles. Let's rename that to Crazy Squiggles. And make a new layer for the carpet borders. Choose a colour that actually shows up. What is going on here? That is not the correct colour that I chose at all. Weird. again, the tracing thing, I'm kind of hoping that something will come of it. Somehow. Just, you're not quite sure what you're doing, but somehow it feels like it is something you need to be doing. It's cold today where I live. What is the temperature at the moment? Actually, let me just have a look. Let me have a look. Degrees, which isn't omega cold, but it's still pretty cold. Going below freezing tonight. I don't know, my feet are just cold. My feet are cold, man. Save this. I quite like it. It's weirdness, isn't it? let's play around with the main image. Let me just duplicate this and unlock that. Move this up. Let's call this one Chop. Chop. Okay. Stretchy mix stretch. Let's unsee these. Oh, look, we've been through for chat. Let's have a look. Just over an hour, not very long, and my brain is already fried. I think what I need is some wine and some blankets and some brain suck TV. Oh, we have the new Peepo Wine emoji emote. Where are you, Peepo Wine? Oh, there we go. Little Peepo Wine. Thank you. Again, what I'm entirely doing, I'm not entirely sure. I'm just playing and seeing what works aesthetically in some sort of way. Looks a little bit like sort of turkey. It's a turkey with the edging. Makes sense, totally. Sorry for the silence, Twitch chat. I am pondering. Shout out Twitch chat. I'm going to call it there. I know it's only been an hour. Super short stream. But I'm cold. And need some food. I need to think about this more. Because I don't know what I'm doing with it. I don't know. Let me just save it. It's a PNG. And yeah, let's just put up this. Okay, thank you for hanging out, everybody who joined and messaged. Really appreciate it. I hope that you are of a temperature that is appropriate to you and comfortable wherever you are around the world. And that you're all well. And I will catch you in the next stream. Thank you so much.